Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this demonstration, I'm going to show you how the prompt object API works inside of AIStor. Let's go ahead and take a look. What we've got right now is a little object store running. It's just got a simple single bucket. And here in my prompt bucket, I've got this single sample text. Now, I don't know what's in that sample text. What I might want to do is ask questions about it. Right? I could open it, I could read it. If it was larger than 4.8K, that would take a while. If I just wanted a summary though, I would like to use AI to do that and an LLM to do that. What I get with my prompt object API is I get a locally deployed inference engine that I can then ask questions about this object. Now, this object doesn't have to be text. It could be images. It could be any number of different things. But this is going to allow me to use that LLM to actually get information about this object from the object itself. Now, in order to do this, I need to deploy prompt. So let me go ahead and show you how to do that. Back in our object store, right down here at the bottom, here is prompt. It's not enabled right now, but I do need to just go ahead and boom, prompt it. Okay, so to get started, browse your data and select an object. And of course, if I browse my data, I get prompt bucket and I get my single object. Now, there's one other thing that you need to do, and that is set up your inference engine. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to my prompt. I'm gonna go to settings, and here on the settings page, right now it's set up to use an external inference engine. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna use a local one, and that local one is already deployed, inference, and that is part of my prompt test here in my local cluster. I go ahead and click that, I click update, and I'm basically good to go. I'm gonna use that local instance so that I'm not sending all of my traffic out over the internet. Now, if I have an external inference engine that I wanna use, I don't wanna deploy prompt everywhere, if I just want to use an external inference engine, I can absolutely do that as well. That is perfectly valid. You just set up your external inference engine, you make sure that it responds to the same queries, and you're good to go. But that is basically it. So now that I've got my inference engine all linked up, I just want to go ahead and browse that data. I'm going to go to my prompt bucket, and I have my sample text. So now that we've got prompt running, let's go ahead and ask a few questions about an object that we've uploaded. So here in my prompt bucket, I've got this sample text. This sample text is actually just a series of quotes from the painter, the artist, Bob Ross, and that I generated using the Bob Ross Lorem Ipsum website. And it's just a jumble of these sort of quotes that he makes. So what are some things that we all know about Bob Ross? We know that he paints, we know that he likes happy little this and that, and he uses clouds and mountains and all that other fun stuff. So we'll take a look at some questions. I'm gonna ask some questions about this, and you'll see that the answers kind of match up with what you would expect. And we're doing this all through the inference engine that again is locally deployed as another service within the pod. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. Here is my prompt object, and I'm gonna just go ahead and let's start with a summary. Summarize this object. So when I say summarize this object, what does it tell me? Well, it comes back and says, hey, this text is a summary of a painting tutorial by Bob Ross. Great, right? It talks about painting a tree and its surroundings, using a fan brush, the importance of using a light touch, and also, again, encourages the viewer to have fun and enjoy the process of creating art. I can ask, say, how many times does the word happy appear in the text? Right? Because it's always happy little clouds and happy little trees. And there it is. The word happy appears 13 times. It's a happy little file is what it is. So what I'm doing here is I'm basically showing you that we can ask questions about this. So let me just go ahead and ask it another question. How often should you do something that makes you happy? And of course, the answer to that question is, according to the text, you should do something that makes you happy every single day. So this is one of the things that just makes me happy is being able to show off all of these happy new features of our prompt object, our prompt API that's bundled in as part of our AI store. I hope you've enjoyed this little demonstration of prompt object. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also connect with us on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.